Kumusta mga kababayan? Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, the basketball show for the Filipino community. Your host for today, Markie-Mark, coming to you live on our set today. And it looks like I'm all alone today, but don't worry, not for long, because we have a very special guest along with PJ coming in later to talk about his experience playing basketball. And as you also can notice, I'm not wearing my scarf today. Why? Because I have a very special scarf that I'm going to wear today. And this is called my ranting scarf, because once this goes on, the rant about the NBA starts. Are you guys ready? The scarf is on and the rant starts now. I want to talk first about Lonzo Ball, because Lonzo Ball has been playing amazing basketball. In the past 14 games, he's been averaging much better numbers than Ben Simmons, the clear-cut rookie of the year. And the thing is that his play has been overshadowed by his loudmouth father, causing so much drama, not just in the NBA, but also for the Lakers. And the fact that his loudmouth father has causing so much of this confusion and all this drama, we can't appreciate the fact that Lonzo Ball has been playing amazing basketball and the game is finally slowing down for him as a point guard. Not just the point guard, but the leader for the Lakers, because without him, the Lakers look lost and they don't know how to play basketball unless they have him. That's really creating shots for everybody and guiding everyone how to play good sense basketball. Not only that, let's go straight up to the fact that not only have we been talking about a lot about Cavs and Warriors, but let's talk about teams that nobody's been appreciating, the Raptors. The Raptors have been playing amazing basketball and they've had a better game against the Warriors than the Cavs. And why are we not giving them a shout out? Not only that, but we're not giving shout outs to teams like Timberwolves. The Timberwolves have been playing amazing basketball and Miami Heat. These guys are a threat, a dark horse in both conferences too. Really knock off a top-seeded team like the Warriors, the Spurs, the Boston Celtics, and the Cavs maybe. So let's give love to these teams like the Miami, who's been grinding, who's been playing hard-nosed defense, and Eric Spoelstra for coaching these hard-nosed guys and playing tough-minded basketball. Not only that, let's go straight up to all these fights that's been happening in the NBA. Guys, the NBA is not about UFC. All these players have been getting into fights. Chris Paul and the Houston Rockets with Blake Griffin and the Clippers. Come on, guys. On your night that you've celebrated, you know, they got a tribute video. And just because you lost, don't be petty about it. Not only that, but then after that, there's been so much fight that's been happening in the NBA. Aaron Aflalo with that hit. Isaiah Thomas hitting, you know, almost cross-facing Andrew Wiggins. Like, all these things, violence in the NBA, let's not go to this, because now everybody's been upset about the ref. I know calls are not being made, but you don't have to resort to violence against each other, right? Because basketball is just basketball. Never fight, right? And let's go straight up to the fact that a lot of these rookies have been so impressive. I don't want to talk more about Ben Simmons. I don't want to talk about Lonzo Ball, but let's talk about Donovan Mitchell. We're not getting enough love from him because he's playing amazing basketball and he's a clear cut, a scorer. He took over what Gordon Hayward's position and role is for the Utah Jazz. Let's give him some love, because he's going to be the future that they're going to build around. He's going to be the type of player that is a go-to scorer and is going to be the future rebuilding process for the Utah Jazz. They're going to surround him with the players that can help him succeed and put them back in the playoff contention. Not only that, but Lauri Markkanen. I've been so impressed by this player. This guy can shoot. This guy's athletic. He's got handles. I can see a lot of Kristaps Porzingis in his game. And I feel like they finally found, you know, people were talking about how much loss it was for Chicago Bulls to lose someone like Jimmy Butler. But the fact that they got a player like Lauri Markkanen and Zach LaVine just came back. And Chris Dunn's playing amazing basketball. Let's not forget the fact that they didn't lose this. They didn't lose this trade. They actually gained a young core, and this was successful for them. And not only that, but it was also successful for the Timberwolves. So I feel like this was a win-win, and this wasn't a bad trade at all. Speaking of a bad trade at all, let's also give props to the OKC Thunder. And now, because of the fact that just because they weren't clicking and they weren't playing well in the beginning, people were saying that this was a lost trade because of the fact that Sabonis and Victor Oladipo has been playing amazing basketball. But now, the OKC Thunder are clicking. Paul George, Carmelo Anthony, Westbrook. They're now learning how to play with each other. And now we're trying to understand and we're trying to appreciate the fact that this wasn't a one-sided trade. Paul George is an amazing basketball player, amazing two-way player, and now he's fitting in well with Westbrook, Carmelo Anthony, and the whole Thunder. And I want to just show love for that, because this wasn't a one-sided, this was also a win-win trade because of the fact that Victor Oladipo and Sabonis are playing amazing basketball, and Victor Oladipo could win. And not win in a sense, but Victor Oladipo could win in a sense of being an all-star this year. And that's all I have for my rant today. I know you guys, I hope you guys enjoy that.